Yo, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It is Ace back with yet another Madden 20 NFL Online head-to-head gameplay. Today, we have the San Francisco 49ers in the Alphabet Series. And San Fran, oh man, guys made the Super Bowl this year and it sucks, man. Unfortunately, I do not know the feeling of getting there to the Super Bowl and losing. I'm an Eagles fan, so I can't tell you how it feels, but the only thing I can say is keep your head up high. You guys have a great roster, a great young roster, and hopefully you guys can translate and do the same thing next year. But before we get into talking about the team, if you guys aren't subscribed, make sure to hit that subscribe button and look at this absolute dime by Jimmy Garoppolo. Definitely going to be in the top 10 plays of the series when all is said and done. But like I said, guys, if you aren't subscribed, make sure to hit the subscribe button. We are at 807 right now. So thank you guys for all the support so far in the series. We're getting there, man. We're getting there. And today was great, man. Madden is treating your boy pretty well, putting us up against some pretty good opponents. Nothing too crazy. I haven't run into a stretch player in a while, so that is very good. But yeah, man, let's get right into the video. So like I said in the last video, we start off these videos just talking about some moves ahead of free agency, or you know, basically things that have already happened in free agency before and during. So let's get right into these moves before we talk about the big ones. So a couple of moves so far that the 49ers have made: they have re-signed Jimmy Ward, Ronald Blair, and Ben Garland, and also tendered Kendrick Bourne and Matt Breida. A lot of those names sound very familiar because once again they are staying in San Fran, and each of those players played a pretty big part in the Super Bowl, if I'm being completely honest. The 49ers, I mean, I'm gonna be honest, your roster is very stacked, but the moves that we are going to talk about are kind of big, you know, in some way. So let's get into the free agents that the 49ers have signed that weren't with the team originally. So the first one is wide receiver Travis Benjamin coming over from the Chargers, and he is going to fill the role of Emmanuel Sanders, who actually just left in free agency to go to the New Orleans Saints. And pretty solid pickup, 49ers fans. I mean, Travis Benjamin, he's basically like another Emmanuel Sanders, except basically a little bit faster. He's a big deep threat. So that's crazy good for them. The next one we're going to talk about is offensive lineman Tom Compton. He might be starting, he might not. He's a veteran in the NFL. He's coming over from the New York Jets, so you know, probably a depth signing. The 49ers O-line is pretty decent the way it is right now. Next one is defensive lineman Kerry Hyder coming over from the Detroit Lions. Probably another just, you know, depth signing. And last one we were going to talk about before basically talking about the big news is linebacker Joe Walker coming over from the Arizona Cardinals. And Joe Walker, he did pretty good for the Cardinals this year. I believe he actually was with the Eagles at one point, and then he moved over to the Cardinals. I believe the Eagles released him, and he went to Arizona, and he played pretty good for them. Now, coming to the 49ers, he's probably not going to be a starter because the 49ers linebacking core is absolutely stacked. And on top of that, I mean, he's probably just going to be a rotational player, who knows, it might be really good. Joe Walker, great signing. So let's move on to the two big signings that have been looming around. Actually, one's not a signing. It was actually a move that they made. But the one signing that we're going to talk about before we get into the move that they made, Arik Armstead, that's even how you pronounce his name. He got signed to a 5-year, $85 million deal to remain with the 49ers. So big move for them right there. They keep one of their defensive linemen. The other one that we're going to talk about, we already made a video on him earlier with the Colts, is none other than DeForest Buckner, who got traded to the Colts for the 13th overall pick in the draft. And it's crazy news coming out of San Fran, because not only do they get that first round pick, but they lose they lose to Forrest Buckner. And I'm going to be honest, guys, watching that Super Bowl and basically just keeping up with the 49ers, DeForest Buckner was a big part of that team. So it's going to be weird to see how they bounce back from that. Of course, they got Nick Bosa on that line, and he's Nick Bosa, so he's going to be making a ton of noise on the line. So nothing to really worry about, I guess. And it's going to be interesting to see what they use that pick on, because now that they have the 13th overall pick, you could get a really good player in that position. And I'm kind of curious as to what position they're going to go for. Do they take a receiver in CeeDee Lamb if he's available, or if they take like a cornerback, or it's just going to be an interesting pick. If they pick an O lineman, it's going to be a little weird in my opinion. But and especially if they pick like a D lineman, that's just going to be like a waste. Like, why wouldn't you just keep DeForest Buckner at that point? But hey, you know, I'm not a GM for a reason. These guys, they know what they're doing. And that's pretty much it for the defense. That defense is stacked. And even though they lost Buckner, I mean, their defense is stacked. I can't even really talk about it that much. Richard Sherman is an NFL legend. I believe, I'm not sure, I could be wrong, but he leads the league in interceptions since he entered the league. Crazy stat. And then on top of that, I mean, it's just, their line is just insane. And then Quan Alexander leading the linebackers, just it's just crazy. It's not too much to talk about, but we can talk about the offense. Jimmy Garoppolo, a lot of people started exposing Garoppolo late in the season. I'm a Jimmy G fan. I loved when he got traded to the 49ers. I thought that he was going to be the future. I still think he is the future. So 49ers fans, don't be nervous. Like I said, you guys just made the Super Bowl. You have a young, talented roster. No need to be scrambling right now. The offense is going to get together. Tevin Coleman is coming back. I believe he was signed like a 2-year deal or something like that. So he is going to be in a contract year. So maybe he'll play a little more spectacular than he was. And then Deebo Samuel, young wide receiver, who right here in the gameplay gets a touchdown right here. Incredible receiver. I mean, he's so good in real life. At Super Bowl, you heard his name every single play. And on top of that, I mean, I'm going to be honest with you guys, I know it's a video game, but he's a monster in Madden. So pretty cool watching the 49ers. Just, they have a lot of young, promising players. And yeah, man, that's all I really have to talk about for this video, guys. We actually did have two gameplays in this video. The first game, I absolutely destroyed the kid. I felt bad. And then this one, we're absolutely destroying him too. And this guy's going to quit eventually. But that's a little plays later. And yeah, man, we got to play two games this video. The first game only lasted so little. The gameplay, if I were to only use the first game, it only would have been like 3 minutes, and that would have been terrible. But we opted into another game, and the 49ers are just that good, man. But that's all I have for today's video, guys. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment, tell me what you guys want to see in this series. Tell me if you guys like this series. And 49ers fans, let me know how you guys feel about the 49ers. Do you think they're going to make the playoffs again next year? Do you think they're going to be as dominant? But as always, guys, it's Ace, and I'll see you in tomorrow's video. Peace.